Hello, I'm Sunanda Banerjee, and I'm currently Head of Marketing for High Life. I have around a decade of experience in business growth and marketing roles, and I'm currently pursuing my PhD in Neuromarketing from Banasthali University. Marketing as a field is not only expanding its horizons every day, but is also innovating itself to stay ahead of times. But like every other area of business, marketing also demands accuracy and precision in its techniques for measuring return on its investments. For which, back in 1876, John Whitemaker famously said, "I know half the money I spend on advertising is wasted, I just do not know which half." Since it is not a very happy thing for companies to spend money and not get a hold of returns, the expenditure should be the investment and not vice versa. Now it's quite challenging but very interesting to explore and build on market research. But it is equally crucial to verify the reliability of the data used when making these decisions. Now, in the process of market research with the conventional methods, it has proven its own set of benefits, but not without the glitches of not knowing of what consumers actually think rather than what they tell, known as the consumer black box. So the idea of introducing or exploring a new technique is not to replace existing ones, but to complement them. So let's put in together that we as marketers seek four types of information about consumers: what they think, what they do, what they feel, and what they say. So neuromarketing is a revolutionary innovative set of techniques in the field that by studying activity in the brain, neuromarketing combines the techniques of neuroscience, clinical psychology, and consumer behavior. So what is neuromarketing in practical applications? Neuromarketing is the formal study where the brain's responses to advertising and branding can be recorded and analyzed. And the adjustment of those messages based on the feedback helps brands and researchers to understand and work on for future requirements that is derived by eliciting specific and accurate responses. With this information, it helps companies to learn on the rationale of consumers' decisions and reasons of choosing a certain response. And very importantly, what parts of the brain are motivating them to do so. Neuromarketing is becoming more and more of a popular answer. Neuromarketing is a science that's based on the fact that 95% of all thoughts, emotions, and learning occur before we are even aware of it. According to Roger Dooley, the author of Neuromarketing and Brain Fluence, that means most of us are actually only talking to 5% of our potential customers' brains. Usage of neuromarketing, you can rethink your strategies and create smarter marketing that will boost the effectiveness of your efforts. Now, these are some of the leading techniques used in neuromarketing, like functional MRI, EEG, eye tracking, etc. These techniques are extremely precise and to understand in a simpler manner. It just means that scientists can read if consumers like or dislike a product, if they would approach or avoid, or if they get excited or bored by a certain advertisement or packaging, etc. Utilizing fMRI involves using a powerful magnet to track the brain's blood flow as subjects respond to audio and visual cues. And EEG, on the other hand, is much cheaper than fMRI, and by using a cap of electrodes attached to the sample's scalp, it also allows for movement. The technique was first explored by Harvard marketing professor Jerry Zaltman in the 1990s. ZMET, which is Zaltman Metaphor Elicitation Technique, is a patent by him and has been used by General Motors, Nestle, Procter & Gamble, and Coca-Cola. Neuromarketing has been around for roughly a decade and only seems to be growing in popularity. Despite its skeptics, naysayers, major corporations have actually used this technology when designing their products, packaging, and advertising campaigns. Breaking through the clutter has proved to be extremely difficult task in this day, an age where marketers are always searching for an advantage. Understanding the most basic roots of human emotions is absolutely vital in comprehending a consumer's purchasing behavior. The beauty of neuromarketing is its ability to integrate into both your outbound and inbound marketing strategies. From things like offering a prospect a warm beverage and seating them a soft chair during a sales conversation, to using pictures of babies in advertising. These are all tactics our brain subconsciously responds to. Awareness of the marketing tactics that could impact your efforts will be the best way to get better results. Now let us understand how it actually works. We'll touch base on just the fundamental concept of the working of these particular techniques. So an individual is presented with a stimulus like a TV or print ad, and the reactions are measured with one of these techniques. It is called priming. It eventually allows the brain to recall everything it knows about the specific topic even before the conscious mind becomes aware of a stimulus. The subconscious mind has already begun to process it and respond, all in the course of a single second. Neuromarketing then is most concerned with what that second when the response is first formed. It allows the brain to compare this new information with what it already knows and to form and express conscious opinions about the product itself. Based on the neural and sensory data collected, the broader teams further develop and adjust the campaigns in order to create maximum engagement and traction. Researcher Reed Montage has designed one of the best known neuromarketing study, trying to explain the difference between preferences expressed in the Pepsi challenge. In this interesting and path-breaking study, people were given two soda drink brands without knowing which is which. People here inevitably chose Pepsi over Coca-Cola, considering only the taste. This is what is known as blind tests. And the results of surveys where people choose Coke over Pepsi when asked about their preferred soda beverage. It was a revolutionary study where it actually came on record that people would really not tell the truth all the time, non-deliberately though. Global packaged goods, flavor and fragrances, houses, media owners, agencies, planners, pharmaceuticals, digital gaming and services are all using these tools these days. Here are some examples of some giant MNCs utilizing neuromarketing like Pepsi, Intel, eBay, ESPN, etc. Brands such as Campbell Soup, Gerber and Frito-Lay have used neuromarketing to restyle their packaging designs. For example, here Axe changed bottle to a more curvy shape and changed the label to make it stand out more. Since then, sales have increased about 5%. Now here is an example of Campbell Soup again, another very famous study. It conducted a 2-year study with 1500 participants and faced much controversy about altering their iconic logo. It eventually decided to keep 3 original labels. Frito-Lay, for instance, discovered matte bags with pictures of potatoes did not trigger a negative response, whereas shiny bags with pictures of chips on them did. Within months, new bags were designed and the shiny ones were scrapped. These are just some of the current applications for utilizing neuromarketing techniques like PR opportunities, profile talking point entry, or measuring effectiveness, or very importantly, de-risking marketing decisions. Now let's move on to a very important part of the whole study. What are the gaps in the area and what is the actual scope for researchers? First, we need to understand why it is so important to research or dive deep in the topic as an academician. Every major marketing research company is acquiring a neuromarketing service provider or developing its own department. For example, Nielsen acquired Neurofocus and Ipsos has its own Neuroscience and Emotion Innovation Center. The literature devoted to neuromarketing is quite young, considering that the first usage of the word neuromarketing appears to date to a June 2002 press release by an Atlanta advertising firm, Bright House, announcing the creation of a business division using fMRI for marketing research. It is unique in its own ways, where it brings fresh viewpoints to the table by uncovering emotional and non-conscious responses. By putting measurements onto common scales, it helps to measure fleeting reactions that people can't remember or fail to comprehend. As seen in previous studies too, asking people to think about how they feel about something can change the feeling and hence can disturb the results of the study. Since literature in the Indian context is limited and there is a need of constant innovation and research in such a disruptive field around which neuromarketing can be understood on academic levels to ensure more interest from scholars to develop the area. Also, from Indian consumers' perspective, is a mystery for most of the marketers, owing to the volume in the business involved and more importantly, the variety of demographics makes it even more challenging to rely on conventional methods only. Being one of the most important economies of the world, global and domestic brands would equally appreciate the need of exploratory research in this area. And what good research can bring on the plate is a phenomenal statistics to back the techniques. which further will enhance the sophistication of the brand approach in the markets. The global market for neuromarketing technology is expected to reach $22 million by 2021 and from $50.3 million in 2016, increasing at a compound annual growth rate of 18% from 2016 to 2021. Cost, scalability, mobility. The three major barriers to adaptation are now being demolished by innovative enterprises that are developing new, portable brain-computer interfaces and eye and facial tracking devices. These combined with advancements in mobile technologies enable researchers to get out of the labs and into real-life situations such as supermarkets, training grounds or workplaces. The availability of low-cost, portable and easy-to-use equipments means new web-based remote testing services are emerging. As a result, larger geographically dispersed samples are possible and statistically significant data gathering is more possible. More research in the area would lead to more collaboration. That means different kinds of research platforms will be used to provide sufficient comparison and effective collaboration. Therefore, the researchers will feel confident to share their outcome. With more number of case studies and research, it will help to understand better, analyze or compare the obtained information and relevant data. It will offer the place for deeper studies of human minds. And greater frequency of testing will enable having effectiveness of time saving and usage will bring the higher volume of trial. It all brings better understanding and overview in neuromarketing, which is critical to the success of the efforts of the brand custodians. So it is the necessary generation of empiristic driven links between measures and behaviors. As these links become clearer, our understanding of unconscious emotional arousal and valence will be able to predict the behavioral outcomes precisely and reliably than ever before. So that, people, would be the end of this module. Thank you for your time and attention. Hope you enjoyed it. Please go through the reference material and explore the subject more. Happy learning.